Hello everyone, my name is Seiji Aida. Today I will talk about this title. So first, this is a train. So first, I will talk about short introduction. Second, I will propose about our method. Then I will explain our experimental setup and tasks. Then I will show the results. And finally, I will conclude our presentation. So next slide we'll show about the introduction about our research in machine translation. Okay, introduction. So neural machine translation, NMT. So its system is widely used. So NMT outputs a wide range of quality. So some translations are very high quality and the others are not so good. This means there may be mistranslations in the results. So we have one question about, can we estimate the quality of the sentence in the process of generation? So we set our goals. So it is outputting only high quality translations. So this means not output low quality translations. So as a result, output sentences is less than the input sentences. So we think the output of the system is very reliable, and this system will help for the translators. So next, I will show our methods of this research. So this is our overview of proposed methods. In the gray rectangle is the current method about NMT. So in the previous work, so current NMT outputs all of input sentences, and the quality of each sentence is high and low. So in our work, we use the NMT features. It is called indices to calculate the confidence value for each sentence. And then when we use the threshold value, we think we can obtain only high quality sentences. So next slide we'll explain about the indices, what we used. So in indices we propose two features. First is sentence log likelihood, and second is average variance. So first one, so sentence log likelihood is very simple index. So as this figure, so current NMT system receive the input sentences and then calculate each part of words and get probability distribution. And then system outputs the most high probability words in each part. So this index use the only high probability words in each sentences. So this index taking the sum of the log probabilities of all output words in the sentence. Like equation is below. So then second one is the average variance. On the last slide, sentence log likelihood use only the top probabilities on each part, but this index use the top 5 probabilities for each part. So average variance using top five candidates to calculate variance from the top in each part of sentence. The equations are below. So we think when we use this index, we can consider how much the model get lost during its generation. So next, I will talk about the experimental tasks. So we propose two tasks in this paper. First one is appropriateness of indices. So we calculate the correlation with the blue. So to check that our indices can be used or not. Next, we using the threshold value, so to check the number of output sentences and average blue score in output sentences. So the model, we used the transformer from the FSEC, and the data, we used aspect JE. JE means Japanese to English, and aspect is the translated scientific papers. This table shows each part of sentences. So next slide will show the experimental results. First one, appropriateness of indices. So we calculate the correlation with the blue. So this table show the results. So as a result, both indices have a weak correlation with blue. So we think we can use both indices as a confidence scoring. Next, so using threshold. So when we change the threshold value, we check the output sentence and the average blue score. So this result, first we used a sentence log likelihood. So this graph shows the results. The blue points is average blue score, and red one is number of sentences. So first, when the threshold value is 0.0, so 1.8 thousand sentences were output, and the average of blue score is 22. But when the threshold value is 0.9, so only 13 sentences were output, but the average blue score was 43. This result shows that when we use this index as a confidence scoring, and we set the threshold, so the output sentences were decreased, but the quality of output sentences is increasing. So next, this is using average variance as an index of confidence scoring. It is the same result to sentence log likelihood. So when the threshold value is 0.2, we can obtain 98 sentences, and the average blue score was 33. So finally, I will conclude my presentation. So we proposed a method calculating the translation confidence from NMT features. So we propose two indices. First one is sentence log likelihood, and second one is average variance. As a result, our method calculating a confidence using NMT feature, it can limit the low quality translations in the process of generation, and we can get high quality translations. That's all. Thank you for listening.